Hey guys, this is Naveen here. Welcome back to Naveen Automation Labs. Guys, today we are going to talk about APM. APM architecture. This is like one of the most important topics in mobile automation. Most of the people, they are not sure about how exactly APM works. Because in APM, there are a lot of things are there, guys. We have iOS drivers, we have Android drivers. What are the different latest tools and technology trends is going on in the market for APM point of view? And a lot of things with respect to APM ecosystem. After 1.6, what happened? Before 1.6, what happened? What are different drivers are available with respect to APM, iOS? Can we test Windows-based application? Can we test a native-based application? How exactly internally internal architecture, you know, is working with respect to APM? How exactly it is different from Selenium WebDriver, like that? And what is the role of JSON via protocol, W3C JSON via protocol, or a typical JSON via protocol? What is the role of that? So today we are going to talk about that, because when I read different blogs, when I read different videos on YouTube, I see that most of the people, they give the wrong information or maybe the half information. And in fact, the number of blogs also that you refer on internet, most of the blogs are outdated. It's not at all updated with the latest trend in APM. So if someone is asking you at a time of interview, I'm pretty much sure after this particular video, you will be able to comfortably you will be able to give the answer. How exactly APM works. It's quite different from WebDriver base. Okay, so in terms of architecture, in terms of implementation and everything. So let's talk about it. So I have written a couple of notes with me. So make sure, because there are so many things, so I'll make sure that I'm not going to forget any single point. So I have written a couple of important notes, and on the basis of that, okay, I'll be preparing. So we are not going to write any code or no coding, nothing. This is simple whiteboard learning. We will do that. So first of all, we know that APM is used for, it's a framework, it's a automation library which is used for mobile automation, right? Whatever you can see on the device, you can automate that. Either it could be your native app, or it could be your hybrid app, it could be your typical browser app also you can open, and then you can automate. And how exactly it works? So APM is mobile automation framework or mobile automation tool, we can say that. And same thing. So let's talk about, let's see, I have, this is my Eclipse. Once again, I'm going to write it, where this is my script, right? It could be anything. It could be a Java. APM supports multiple languages. We have Java, C#, .NET, Python, PHP, Perl, everything. So let's see, I'm going to write my Java code over here, or maybe JavaScript, or maybe Python, whatever, it doesn't matter. So this is my script at the client level that I'm going to use APM library, right? I'm going to use APM library over here, or APM client libraries over here, and then I'm going to write some code over here, right guys? Then what happens? Then there is a APM server is running actually. So this is, I would say, let's see, this is my APM server is running, right? This is my, you have to install APM, then you have to start APM server. And this APM server is written in node.js. So this is my node server actually. So APM is actually running on my node server. And then what happens, guys? When I send my request to the APM server, hey, what kind of automation that you want? So I'm going to send my request to the APM server in the form of client server architecture. So this will behave like a client for me, and this is my server. Right? So a typical client server architecture. So APM is totally based out of client server architecture. So we are going to send one HTTP request to this guy, and then this request will be sent in the form of JSON wire protocol. So I would say JSON wire protocol over here, like that. Or it could be a typical W3C WebDriver JSON also, that also you can do that. And that will be my HTTP request I'm going to send to this guy, to the server. Now, server is capable enough to understand the request. Along with the request, I'm going to pass that, these are my desired capabilities. Okay, what are the desired capabilities? Let's see, whatever, right? It could be anything on which device I want to run, what is my APM activities or other, packages, information, and all those things I'll be passing over here. So I'm not very much talking about desired capabilities over here, but client will interact with your server over here. Now, another thing that you need to remember, right? Let's talk about the iOS flow, how exactly iOS works. Now, remember one thing, this is the latest thing you can have written over here. What happens that after iOS 9.3, guys, there is another component that we have to know about that is called XEUI test. Okay, so I simply write XEUI test over here. This is the guy, this is the driver, this will behave like a driver for me. Okay, this XEUI test is a library for me, will behave like a driver for me, which will available after iOS, remember one thing, 9.3. So if your iOS version is greater than 9.3, then you have to use XEUI test driver version, that you have to do that. Right, before 9.3, I'll tell you in some time. So for iOS 10 onwards, right, after iOS 9.3 and 10 onwards, we will be using XEUI test driver internally. Okay, now what happens after that? We will send the request to the WebDriver one agent over here. So this is called WebDriver agent. Okay guys, this is my WebDriver agent. I'll write for you guys. I hope you can see that. Now this WebDriver agent is developed by Facebook. Okay, remember this thing, it is developed by Facebook. This is not your typical WebDriver. I'm not talking about selling WebDriver. This is a WebDriver agent. The name itself is WebDriver agent. And this is developed by Facebook development team, especially for iOS folks. And this WebDriver agent will be interacting with your devices. So let's see, you have a typical iOS device. This is your device, or it could be connected to your simulator also. So when we talk about iOS, we talk about, we say simulators, not emulators. So on iOS, we talk about simulators. So simulator is just like a virtual device for you, and it's a physical device that we have, and where your application is running, your app is running over here, right? Like that. Either it could be a physical device or it could be a simulator also. So this is the architecture I'm going to talk about, guys, after iOS 9.3 or iOS 10. Okay, time 10 onwards, we are going to use this particular concept, right? Now, if the lower version you are using, iOS less than 9.3 version, so in that case, what we have to do, in that case, we are going to send this particular request to the server, and we are, on the basis of that, it will decide that, okay, hey, which iOS you want to run. So I simply say that, okay, now this time I'm going to use another component. I'm not going to use XEUI test over here. Remember this thing, this is one of the most important topic you have to understand. Right guys, this is the most important point you have to understand. Most of the people, they miss this particular important thing over here. So here, what I'm going to write, this is a UI automation concept, you must have heard about it. UI automation. There is a module, UI automation library, we will be using for this particular module. UI automation module, I'll be using for, if your iOS version is less than 9.3, remember this thing guys. Okay, less than 9.3. Now, then in that case, do I need WebDriver agent? No. Now this particular UI automation will directly connect to the app over here. So we have directly, we have, it will connect to the app or your simulators. Let's see, like that. And like this, right? Ultimately, end of the result is what? End result is what? We have to connect to the devices and the simulators. But if you're talking about greater than 9.3 and iOS 10, in that case, you have to use XEUI test driver library, then we have to use WebDriver agent, and then on the iOS device we are using, okay, this particular application, and this WebDriver agent will perform some action on these devices. But if you're talking about iOS less than 9.3, in that case what we have to do, in that case we have to use a UI automation module over here, right guys? And these XEUI test driver and UI automation module provided by Apple, not by Selenium guys or not by APM guys, provided by Apple. This is the Apple proprietary. Okay, now one thing, UI automation, one small thing you need to understand, that when we are talking about less than 9.3, so there is one JS file that is called bootstrap.js file, bootstrap.javascript file. So what will happen, APM server will inject bootstrap.js to the device side or to the simulator side to perform some action on these devices. So bootstrap.js, whatever the action that you are sending, right, either dot click or dot send keys or tap or scrolling or whatever, everything is happening through UI automation module. UI automation module will transfer all these commands to bootstrap.js, and bootstrap.js will help this UI automation module to perform some action on your devices.
on these apps like that.
What kind of actions? Either it could be click, either it could be tap, either it could be, let's see, type something, either it could be kill the app. Something like this will happen through this. Okay, but if you're talking about iOS greater than 9.3 with the help of WebDriver agent, which is developed by Facebook, this WebDriver agent is used to launch the app, is used to, let's see, tap something, used to type something, used to kill the app also. So all these things are done by WebDriver agent on this particular device or simulator. Now you understood, right guys? Now, how exactly server will decide that we have to go to this particular path or we have to select this particular path, right? This will be decided by from your script, from the client script, what kind of desired capability that you are passing, right guys? So for desired capability point of view, if you are passing desired capability is equal to, so we have to pass one desired capability over here. I'll pass, that is the name is automation name we have to pass. So I exactly name I'm writing over here, automation name capability you have to pass, and this desired capability is equal to X UI. If it is equal to X UI test, it means pick this particular flow. Okay, this X UI test and WebDriver agent flow. If your desired capabilities over here, right, again automation name, I'll write automation name is equal to, if it is equal to what, UI automation, right guys, it means you pick this particular flow. Right, I'm pretty much sure you know the concept of desired capabilities. It means when we initialize a web driver, that time I will create the object of desired capabilities, and then I'll pass APM server which is running on some machine. Let's see 192.168.1.10, and it's running on some, let's see, 9268 IP port number or something like this. So through the remote web driver or through the desired capability, we will connect to this particular node server. And we will pass the desired capabilities object over here, and we will pass this automation name, which is a very important factor. Okay, and then we will decide, okay, hey, XUI test means my device is having greater than 9.3 or 10 or 11, 13 or whatever iOS version on these apps, on these devices. If it is less than 9.3, which is nowadays in 2020 is a very rare case, most of the people, they have migrated to, okay, iOS 13 now. So we have to, most of the time, we have to pick this particular flow. But this is the thing, guys. This is the old architecture, actually. This is the old, okay, mechanism. And this is a new one, actually. I hope it's clear now. So APM 1.6, right, guys? APM 1.6 will start. They have implemented this particular flow, XUI test, like that. So this is the, what? This is iOS architecture. This is what iOS. I hope it's clear. So you can take a screenshot. Please print it out. And then learn, practice. This is what exactly you have to explain at the time of interview. Okay, now I'm going to rub this particular thing, then I'm going to show you how exactly it works for Android now. Now we will talk about, now we are going to talk about Android flow. How exactly Android works. Okay, guys, concept will remain same. My client library, APM server is running through the node, on the node server, like that. And then for Android, what happens, it will pass to another module. That module is called, okay, the module is called UI Automator 2. I'll write UI, okay, 1 second, Automator 2. Okay, and in iOS we used to use UI automation. So don't be confused. Here we are going to use UI automator. Okay, guys. So please make sure that, okay, right. So UI automator 2 in the Android case we will pass. So request will be sent to the UI automator 2 module. And this UI automator 2, what exactly it will do? This is the APM module, actually. Remember then? This is available inside the APM. This is the APM module provided by Google. Okay. This is the framework provided by Google. This is the API module. Now, this UI automator 2 will connect to your devices. Either it could be, again, physical devices, or it could be your emulator. So when we talk about Android, we call it emulator. And this is my device, actually physical device. You connect to your laptop and then app is running on this, or it could be running on this also. Your application, your native application is running on this. Right, guys? So now UI automator is responsible, responsible to perform some action. Okay, launch the application, kill, okay, type, tap, scrolling, everything through UI automator 2 module. We have to do that. But here, UI automator 2, what exactly it uses? It uses one important concept over here. It uses one jar file. And you need to remember that jar file module over here, that is called APM. I would tell you APM Android, exact name I'm going to tell you, APM Android. Okay, Bootstrap jar. APM Android Bootstrap jar, you have to use it. Now, same thing, APM module will instruct to this particular guy, and this jar file will help me or help this particular UI automator to perform some action on this particular app that you have it. Either it would be Amazon app or whatever the app, or Walmart app, or whatever app that you have. Okay, like that. So this is same concept, but what kind of desired capability we have to pass? So when we talk about the desired capabilities over here, the same desired capabilities we have to pass. My desired capabilities, this time my automation name is, I would say automation name is what? UI automator 2 you have to pass. Right, don't be confused. UI automation is for iOS. That is again before 9.3. For latest, we have to use XCUI test, but for Android, we have to use UI automated 2. Do we have old version? Yes, we have old version also, which is still available, but hardly we use it. That is called UI automator 1. For old Android devices, we have UI automator 1. It is almost deprecated, we don't use it. And this will connect to your physical devices or the emulator, like that. So same thing, you have to pass the UI automator. I would write UI as a desired capability. You have to pass UI automator 1 desired capabilities. You have to pass for this particular flow. Okay, but latest trend is, this is the new one, we have to use that. Who provides this? Google. Right, guys? So this is the concept for Android now. I hope this is clear. Right? Now, whenever we are launching from the client side, we will decide that, okay, hey, this is the APM server. With the help of node.js, we will start the server, send the request, and the specific flow will be executed like that. So this is for Android architecture. You have to understand that. Okay? Now, I'm just going to rub it. And then I'll give you one more information. You will get this particular information from the official site of APM. So let me rub this. Okay. So likewise, what happens is that we use this. Okay. Yeah. So likewise, what happens that we have different drivers are available. APM ecosystem is very huge, different drivers are available. So now one by one, I'm going to talk about some information on different drivers also. What are different drivers are available? So I would say that, see, this is my test script. Okay, this is my test script over here, from the script that you are writing it. And then I'll be using my APM client library. Okay, these are my APM client libraries, and then we have APM main module is available over here, like that. Simple. Now, by using this particular APM main module, there are so different tools are available, provided by Google, provided by Google and Apple or different companies. You can use that actually.
So let's talk about a typical thing that we have already talked about for iOS and Android. So let's see, I'm going to use APM to what? UI Automator second driver I'm going to use it. So this is another driver. So today in this particular module, I'm going to talk about what are the different other drivers are available. That this driver is typically used for what? For iOS and Android. So it will launch for your Android device. Okay, for Android, right? I hope this is visible now, right? Same thing, if you really want to use, you must have heard about Espresso driver. So Espresso driver is especially designed for, Android. So which is again designed by Google. So we have Espresso driver is also available, guys. So all these drivers are actually extending APM module, okay? Extending APM classes, and then Espresso driver is available. And this Espresso driver, what exactly will start one Espresso server? Okay, so this is one customized Espresso server is available. This is, or we can say that some people say that okay, no, we have a different tool is available. Actually, Espresso is internally using APM, okay? APM client libraries only. And then they will be giving you Espresso driver. Again, this is developed by Google only. Okay, by Google team only. And this particular Espresso server, they will be using what? They will be using Espresso modules over here. And then it is used only and only for Android devices. Android devices. So ultimately, you're running your app on devices. This is my, again, Android device and running the app over here. So this is UI Automator 2. If you're directly using APM, you can use that. If you really want to use Espresso, you can use Espresso driver separately, and then you can use the same fundamentals. You can do that. Do we have any support for Microsoft for the Windows based application? Yes, you must have heard about WinApp driver that I've already talked about. So by using this APM only, we have another driver which is provided by Microsoft, that is called Window driver. Okay, now this particular Window driver will be giving you one WinApp driver over here. Okay, so this is for Window driver. So it will give you WinApp driver. I have one video also, you must have seen that. WinApp driver for what? For Window application. For Windows based application, you can automate. If you really want to use that for Windows based application also, you can do that. Do we have something for Mac? For Mac apps, only for those apps which are available in the MacBook. Do we have that? Yes. We have another implementation provided by Apple that is called Mac driver. So we have one more Mac driver is also available. Okay guys, now this particular Mac driver will give you APM Mac module. APM Mac, and this is used for what? For your Mac apps. So whatever the Mac based applications are there for Mac machines, so you can simply do that. This is also another concept provided by this. Okay, for iOS, we have already talked about. For iOS, we have already talked about that we have this thing, XUI test also. XUI test, which will talk to your WebDriver agent, WD agent, and then it will connect to your, devices app over here for your iOS devices app. That we have already seen that. We have another concept that we have already seen, that is again for iOS implementation, we have UI automation. Right, guys? UI automation for less than 9.3, right? For again, which is used for iOS apps. Like that, we have this. Okay, so UI automation, we have seen that. XUI test, we have seen that. Espresso, we have. UI Automator 2 driver for Android. For Mac driver, we have that. Window driver also, we have that. There are some other companies also, they provide the same implementation. I would give you, I have another information with me. That is called a UI driver, UI. So we have, I just forgot this particular name. Let me check. I have this particular in my paper, UI driver, yes. UI driver. This is another customized implementation available for UI enabled apps. Okay, although I have never used this, but if someone is asking you, this is called UI enabled apps. Okay, only for UI enabled apps. So although most of the people, I mean, we don't generally don't use that. If your app are based out of UI driver, you can use that. I'm not talking about UI, it's YOUI driver implementation is available. Okay, then one more thing is available for the Samsung devices provided by Samsung. That is called Tizen driver. Okay, so one Tizen driver is also available. I would write it over here. This is called Tizen. Okay, so Tizen driver is available only for Samsung apps. Only for Samsung application, for the Samsung devices, you can use that. Okay, what else? So how many flows we have seen? See, let's see, this is one, this is two, this is third, four, five, six, seven. Seven drivers we have seen that. Now, do we have anything for, I would write it like this. Do we have anything for browser? Let's see, I want to launch Chrome on Android browser. So for that purpose also, what we have to do that, with the two ways we can do that. Either you can use the UI automator also, you can do that. Okay, and you can use the Espresso driver also, you can simply do that. So both, they provide one concept is called what? Chrome driver, they will give it to you, Chrome driver. I'll write Chrome driver over here. And to launch Chrome browser, where? To launch Chrome driver in your Android devices. So this is my Chrome. Let's see, this is Chrome on Android. You can simply do that. Okay. So excavators, we have already seen that. Android devices, we have already seen that for Android website or Android web, actually, for web application. This is okay. You can simply do that. And Windows app, we can see that. Mac app, we have seen that. And we have already seen. And excavators, we have seen. UI automator, we have seen. So this is my 7th and 8th flow. 8th driver actually. So this is the complete different drivers which are available in the market. So this is a whole ecosystem of APM, guys. Now you can imagine this is but huge, right? But most of the time, where exactly you will be working, most of the time you will be working with the UI automator 2 driver for Android devices, and you will be using this X UI test. So in my current company also, we are using this and this particular flow and this particular test, right? Now, someone says, okay, you know, I don't want to use a typical APM library, because this APM, whatever the iOS driver provided by APM to automate the app devices on iOS, what exactly they have done, they have created certain wrappers on top of XUI test library. On top of XUI test library, they have created some wrappers over here. Right, so that's why APM is slightly slow on iOS devices, because it will send the request to the XUI library, and then this library will be connected into the WebDriver agent and perform some action on the app devices over there, okay, with the help of XUI test library on the devices. So that's why iOS flow is a little slow. If you want to make it real fast, you can avoid APM. What you can do, you can directly write your test cases with the help of XUI test library. You can use that particular library, which will help you to connect to the device and app is running over here. This is a separate thing, okay, for iOS. Okay, if you don't want to use APM library, but here you have to write your code in Swift. So you should know about Swift over here. Swift is a programming language, you have to do that. Earlier it was Objective-C. Okay, so here we have to use Swift test cases, which are quite easy. You can simply learn it, not a big deal. You can do that, okay. So this is the thing, guys, that is the trend over here. Same thing for if you directly want to use UI automator driver APIs to automate Android, that also you can do that. So when we automate this thing, right, when we automate Android, so we will be using the combination of both APM And the UI automated driver APIs also, we can do that. So let's say your Dotlink is not working with the help of APM, or type is not working, or some specific element is hidden, we are not able to click on it or something like this. In that case, we can use UI automated route driver, which is directly interacting with the Android native APIs on Android operating system. And with the help of this, we can directly do that on Android devices. So this is the combination, we can use that. But APM is very vast, very great tool, no doubt about it. But the problem is the ecosystem is so huge, right? So we, on the basis of your requirement, you pick the specific driver and then accordingly you proceed further. So this thing is provided by Google. This is also provided by Google. And this is the implementation of Apple. And this is the implementation of Microsoft, provided by Microsoft. Okay, like that. I hope it's clear now. Now, the last thing is that, can we create my own driver? Let's say I want to create Naveen driver. Yes, we can do that. So all these modules, right, they are actually the implementation of APM. This is the main core APM library. And the concept is same, that, okay, we have to start the server and then respective driver will connect to, okay, do that. Let's say in case of Espresso, they have provided one separate Espresso server over there. But let's say tomorrow I want to create my own library. I want to create my own customized library on top of APM. Let's say I want to create that something. That over here, that okay, Naveen APM driver, Naveen APM okay driver for Android and iOS separately, for Android and iOS, that I can do that, which is also possible. Some people, they do it actually. In some companies, they customize these drivers, they create their own customized drivers and they automate Android and iOS like that. Okay, so I hope it's clear now. And okay, please understand this, try to learn as much as possible, because you should be aware of the latest tools, technologies and the ecosystem of APM, which is quite important. And before that, two diagrams I have shown you, one is for iOS and one is for Android architecture. With this thing, I'm pretty much sure you can easily explain at a time of interview. And if you have this mindset in your mind that, okay, hey, this is how exactly APM works, you will easily automate such APIs or such apps also on different devices. Okay, it's, I know, difficult to learn each and everything. I mean, difficult to remember each and everything, but this is the way. Okay, we have to do that. Okay, so with this thing, that's all for today. I hope you are liking this whiteboard learning. Please provide me the feedback and please let me know on which topic you want me to prepare for whiteboard learning. Okay. So thank you so much, guys. Thanks for watching Naveen Automation Labs. And please like, subscribe and share to this particular video so that most of the people, they will get benefit out of it. Thank you so much. Bye-bye.